Example number 8 from the practice set 2.6. The question is, Pintu takes 6 days more than those of Nishu to complete a certain work. If they work together, they finish it in 4 days. How many days would it take to complete the work alone? Here the information given is Pintu takes 6 days more than those of Nishu. We know the number of days taken by Pintu to complete the work alone, that is 6 more than those of Nishu. But we didn't know how many days are required to complete the work alone by Nishu. We know the number of days taken by Pintu, it is depend upon the number of days taken by Nishu. So, we will consider the number of days taken by Nishu to complete the work alone, and then we will easily get the number of days taken by Pintu. So, here we will write here, let number of days taken by Nishu is equal to x. Number of days taken by Nishu to complete the work alone, that is equal to x. Now we can easily get the number of days taken by Pintu, and that is 6 more, means x plus 6. So here we will write number of days taken by Pintu to complete the work alone, that is equal to x plus 6 days, that is equal to x plus 6 days. And now the given condition is too easy. If they work together, they finish it in 4 days. If both the persons work together, then they will finish that work in 4 days. If they work together. So, first of all, we have to find how much work done by Nishu in 4 days and how much work done by Pintu in 4 days. And then the sum of their works, that is equal to 1. One work is completed in 4 days. So, here we have to get the work done by Nishu in 4 days and the work done by Pintu in 4 days. So, how we will get the work done by Nishu in 4 days and the work done by Pintu in 4 days? So, first we will get how much work is done by Nishu in 1 day. How much work done by Nishu in the 1 day? So, we will get the work done by Nishu in 4 days. Easily we will get, if we know how much work done by Nishu in a single day, then we will easily get how much work done by Nishu in 4 days, multiplying that number by 4. But how to get the work done by Nishu in 1 day or in a single day? So, here we will write work done by Nishu, in 4 days. Directly we will write the work done by Nishu in 4 days, and that is 4 upon x. Work done by Nishu in 4 days, that is equal to 4 upon x. How we get this 4 upon x? We will explain here. How we get the work done by Nishu in 4 days, that is 4 upon x. Here we consider that Nishu completes a work. Nishu completes a work in x days. Number of days x, and the work done is 1. To complete a work alone, Nishu take x days. Now we have to find the work done by Nishu in 1 day. Here we get एक्स डेज, इन एक्स डेज शी कंप्लीट्स वन वर्क, इन एक्स डेज शी कंप्लीट्स वन वर्क. नाउ वी हैव टू गेट इन वन डे हाउ मच वर्क इज डन बाय निशु. सो वी विल राइट हियर वन इन द कॉलम ऑफ डेज, वी विल राइट वन, एंड हियर वी डिडंट नो हाउ मच वर्क इज डन, सो वी विल रिप्रेजेंट इट एज एनी अननोन वेरिएबल और एनी सिम्बॉल, मे बी अल्फा बीटा और यू कैन टेक एनी सिम्बॉल देयर. वी विल टेक डब्ल्यू फॉर वर्क, वी विल यूज डब्ल्यू फॉर वर्क. एंड नाउ वी हैव टू गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ डब्ल्यू, सीन्स हेयर इन द नंबर ऑफ डेज एंड द वर्क डन वी हैव डायरेक्ट वेरिएशन, एंड इन द डायरेक्ट वेरिएशन डिविजन ऑफ द टू क्वान्टिटीज इज सेम, डिविजन ऑफ द टू क्वान्टिटीज इज द सेम. सो डायरेक्टली वी विल टेक क्रॉस मल्टीप्लीकेशन. सी एक्स अपॉन वन इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन डब्ल्यू, यू कैन राइट लाइक दैट, बट वी विल डायरेक्टली टेक क्रॉस मल्टीप्लीकेशंस. एक्स मल्टीप्लाइड बाय डब्ल्यू दैट इज इक्वल टू वन मल्टीप्लाइड बाय वन दैट इज वन, एंड हियर वी गेट डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन एक्स. वी हैव टू गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ डब्ल्यू दैट इज वर्क डन बाय निशु इन वन डे, एंड इट इज वन अपॉन एक्स. इन वन डे, इन अ सिंगल डे, निशु वर्क्स वन अपॉन एक्स, शी कंप्लीट द वर्क वन अपॉन एक्स इन अ सिंगल डे. सो हाउ मच वर्क डन बाय निशु इन फोर डेज, सो वी विल सिंपली मल्टीप्लाय दिस नंबर बाय फोर. दिस इज द वर्क डन बाय निशु इन वन डे, सो वी विल मल्टीप्लाय दिस नंबर बाय फोर एंड वी विल गेट फोर अपॉन एक्स. सो वी राइट हियर वर्क डन बाय निशु इन फोर डेज दैट इज इक्वल टू 4 upon x. And now you can simply get the work done by Pintu in 4 days. We can simply get the work done by Pintu in 4 days, that is 4 upon x plus 6. So here we will directly write work done by Pintu in 4 days, that is equal to 4 upon x plus 6. This is not necessary to write here. This is just your kind of information. How we get the work done by Nishu in 4 days, that is 4 upon x, and how we get the work done by Pintu in 4 days, that is 4 upon x plus 6. Simply here in place of x, we have x plus 6, and work done by Pintu is 1. In x plus 6 days, he completes 1 work. So how much work he completed in one day, so we will take it as w. Here we have x plus 6, then we will write here x plus 6, here also x plus 6, 1 upon x plus 6, that is the work done by Pintu in one day. So in 4 days, 4 upon x plus 6, and it is given that in the given condition, see, we have given that if both work together, if both the persons work together, Pintu and Nishu, they complete the work in 4 days. So here we can write by using given condition, by using given condition, 4 upon x, that is the work done by Nishu in 4 days, plus they worked together, so we have to take addition. This is the work done by Nishu and this is the work done by Pintu, and this is equal to 1. If they work together, one work is gets completed. If they work together 4 days, then the one work is gets completed. So here we write 4 upon x, that is the work done by Nishu, 4 upon x plus 6, that is the work done by Pintu, and that is equal to 1. One work is gets completed in 4 days if they work together. They work together, so we take addition. 4 upon x plus 4 upon x plus 6 is equal to 1. And now we can easily simplify. We will frame the quadratic equation first, and then we will solve this quadratic equation by one of the three methods, that is factorization method, completing square method, or factorization method. So here we have to take the multiplication of denominator to the denominator and cross multiplication to the numerator, or simply we can take 4 common. Simply we can take 4 common from both the terms, and we will transfer that 4 to the right side. So here we will get 4 into the bracket 1 upon x plus 1 upon x plus 6, that is equal to 1, and this 4 is transferred to the right side, we will get 1 upon x
plus 1 upon x plus 6 is equal to 1 upon 4. Now we will take addition. Multiplication of denominator to the denominator, that is x square plus 6x. Cross multiplication is to the numerator, that is x plus 6 into 1, x plus 6 plus x multiplied by 1 is x, that is equal to 1 upon 4 as it is. Now this is x plus x to x plus 6 divided by x square plus 6x, it is equal to 1 upon 4. We will simplify this. 2x plus 6 upon x square plus 6x, that is equal to 1 upon 4. Now taking cross multiplications, x square plus 6x into 1, that is x square plus 6x, it is equal to 4 multiplied by 2x, that is 8x, plus 4 multiplied by 6, that is 24. Now transfer both these terms to the left side and we will get x square plus 6x minus 4 to the 8x. Here we have 8x. This 8x is transferred to the left side, we will get minus 8x minus 24, that is equal to 0. Now here 6x minus 8x, that is minus 2x minus 24, it is equal to 0. And now we have to get the factors of 24 such that their difference is 2. And the factors are 6 and 4. 6 4s are 24 and the difference between 6 and 4 is 2. So here we will write x square minus 6x plus 4x minus 24 equal to 0. From the first two terms we take x common, inside the bracket x minus 6 is remaining, plus 4 is taken common and inside the bracket x minus 6 is remaining, that is equal to 0. X minus 6 into x plus 4, that is equal to 0. And we have x minus 6 is equal to 0 or x plus 4 is equal to 0. Now we have x is equal to 6 or x is equal to minus 4. Since x is the number of days, that should not be negative. Number of days never be negative. So this value is unacceptable. So here we will write number of days never be negative. Number of days never negative. Therefore, x is not equal to minus 4. So we have x is equal to 6. And now we get the answer, that is the number of days taken by Nishu to complete the work alone, that is equal to 6. Here x is not equal to minus 4. We get number of days taken by Nishu to complete the work alone, that is 6. And now 6 more days taken by Pintu. So Pintu takes 12 days to complete that work alone. Here we write example number 9. If 460 is divided by a natural number, the quotient is 6 more than 5 times the divisor and remainder is 1, find the quotient and divisor. Here we have given that 460 is a number and it is divided by a natural number, but we didn't know that natural number. So we have to consider that natural number and we will take it as x, and that is divided by a natural number, the number to which we divide. See this 460, we divide this 460, so 460 is called as dividend. We divide this 460, so this 460 is called as dividend, and we divide it by a natural number, that is x. We divide it by a natural number which is called as divisor, the number by which we divide, the number by which we divide to the dividend, that is called as divisor. Since we have to find the divisor, we will take it as x, and that is natural number. Now it is given that quotient is, we have given the quotient, quotient is 6 more than the 5 times the divisor. Quotient is also given, it is 6 more than the 5 times the divisor. Means we know the quotient, but it is depend upon the divisor, but we didn't know divisor. So we have to consider a divisor.
and that is a natural number. Divisor is a natural number, so we will represent it by x, and then we have to find the value of x. So here we will write let x be the divisor. Let x be the divisor. So we will find the quotient. Therefore, quotient is equal to. Therefore, quotient is equal to. As we know that quotient is 6 more than 5 times the divisor. 6 more than 5 times the divisor. The divisor is x. 5 times the divisor is 5x. And quotient is 6 more than the divisor. So it is 5x plus 6. And the remainder is given, that is 1. Remainder is already given, that is 1. Remainder is equal to 1. Now, by using given condition, now what is the given condition? Actually, the condition is not given into the example, but we knows when we have given dividend, divisor, that is natural number, quotient and remainder, then we have Euclid's division lemma to use here. And what is the Euclid's division lemma? Euclid's division lemma states that dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Here we will write Euclid's division lemma, that is related with all these terms, dividend, divisor, quotient and remainder. We have dividend 460, we have divisor x, we have quotient 5x plus 6, and we have remainder 1. And we have Euclid's division lemma, which belongs to all these terms, and that is dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So here we will write that Euclid's division lemma, dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. And now we have to put the values here. Euclid's division lemma, that is dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. And now we have to put the values there. We have to put the values there. Dividend is 460. Dividend is the number to which we divide, that is 460. So we write 460 here, is equal to divisor is natural number, that is x, multiplied by quotient is 5x plus 6 plus remainder is 1. And now simplifying this, we will get a quadratic equation, and then we have to simplify that quadratic equation, and we have to find the quotient and divisor. So here we will take multiplication. This 460 remains as it is, or you will transfer this one to the left side, and then we will multiply, or first we will take multiplication and then we will transfer this 460 to the right side. So x into 5x, that is 5x square, plus x into 6, that is 6x plus 1 as it is. Now we will transfer this 460 to the right side and we will get a quadratic equation, that is 5x square plus 6x plus 1 minus 460, that is equal to 0. We transfer this 460 to the right side and nothing is there in the left side remaining, means we have 0 there. So we will simplify this. 5x square plus 6x minus 459, that is equal to 0. 460 negative plus 1, and the subtraction is minus 459. And now we have to simplify this quadratic equation. We have to factorize the product of 5 and 459 such that their difference is 6. Or we can use formula method here. Already the given equation is in the standard form. Since we have bigger number here, 459 multiplied by 5, this number is more than 2000, and then we have to get the factors of that number such that their difference is 6. So that is time consuming. So we can
easily solve this quadratic equation by the factorization method here. So by comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, we have a is equal to 5, we have b is equal to 6, and we have c is equal to minus 4 plus 459. First we will get the value of b square minus 4ac. It is b square minus 4ac is equal to 6 square minus 4 into 5 into minus 459. Now b square minus 4ac is equal to 6 square is 36, this is minus into minus, plus 4 5s are 20 multiplied by 459, this is 36 as it is, plus product of 20 and 459, we'll put this 0 as it is, and twice of 459, or you can multiply 459 by 2 only. 2 9s are 18, 2 5s are 10 plus 1 11, 1 is carried, 2 4s are 8 plus 1 9, and the sum is 6 plus 0 is 6, 8 plus 3 11, 1 carried, 1 plus 1 is 2, and this is 9, remains as it is. B square minus 4ac is equal to 9216. Now we have to put all these values of a, b and c and b square minus 4ac into the formula. We have formula x is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a. Put the values here. X is equal to this minus sign as it is, value of b is 6, this is minus 6, plus or minus square root of 9216 upon 2 into a, that is 2 into 5. Now we have to simplify this. X is equal to minus 6 plus or minus. Now we have to get the square root of 9216. As we know that the square of 100 is 10,000. The square of 100 is 10,000. And this number is near to the 10,000, 9216. Now if we take the square of 90, square of 99 square is 81, and we put two zeros there. So it is 8,100, that is the square of 90. 8,100, square of 100 is 10,000, and this number lies between 8,100 and the 10,000. And we have 6 in the units place. We know that when we get 6 in the units place after making square, if there is 6 or 4 in the units place, means the square root of this number either 94 or 96. Square root of this number is either 94 or 96. Now we have to check for that, whether the square root of 94 is 9216, or the square of 96 is 9216. Once again we will take 95, the center number between 90 and 195 is there, and we know that how to make the square of number having units place 5, that is 5 square is 25 and 9 tens are 90, that is 9025, that is the square of 95. Square of 95, 5 square is 25 and 9 after 19 is there, 19 is 90, and this number is greater than 9025, means definitely the square root of this number is 96. So we will put there 96, we will put 96 here, square root of 9216, that is 96 divided by 10, this is x is equal to minus 6 plus 96 divided by 10, or x is equal to minus 6 minus 96 divided by 10. This is x is equal to 90 divided by 10, or x is equal to minus 102 divided by 10. Since x is natural number, see, divided by a
natural number. Our divisor is natural x is natural number. This is not natural number. Minus sign is there. We'll take division here. X is equal to 9 or x is equal to, we can write, we can divide both the numbers by 2. Minus sign remains at, as it is, 2 5 is 10, 2 1 is 2, 2 5 is 10, minus 51 upon 5. But it is not a natural number. Since divisor is a natural number, divisor is natural number. Divisor is natural number, therefore x is not equal to minus 51 upon 5 and x is equal to 9. So the divisor is 9, and now we have to find the quotients. 9 5 are 45 plus 6 is 51. So here we will write divisor is 9 and quotient is 51, and quotient is 51. We get both the values, that is divisor and quotient. You can simplify this quadratic equation by factorization method also, but it will take time. Here also we take time to find the square root of 9216. So you may solve that quadratic equation by the factorization method or the formula method. You can use any method. So this is all about example number 10, which is an activity. In the adjoining figure, quadrilateral ABCD is trapezium, AB is parallel to CD, and its area is 33 square centimeter. From the information given in the figure, find the length of all the sides of quadrilateral ABCD. Fill in the empty boxes to get the solution. We have to fill the empty boxes properly, means we have to write the proper number or name of the side or the proper variable into the empty boxes. Here we have given quadrilateral ABCD is trapezium, AB is parallel to CD. Area of quadrilateral ABCD is equal to half into the bracket AB plus CD multiplied by empty box. Now here in this empty box we have to write the proper name of the side. As we have given the name of quadrilateral here, as we have given the names of the sides here, we know the formula for finding the area of the trapezium. That is, area of trapezium is equal to half into sum of the parallel sides into height, and the height given in the diagram is AM. So we have to write AM here. Now here in this box or in the next step, we have given the values. That is, area of quadrilateral ABCD is 33, half as it is in place of AB, x is there in place of CD, 2x plus 1 is there, and in place of AM we have to put x minus 4 there. Now here some steps were skipped, some steps are illuminated, not the next step is given here, some steps are illuminated, and we have to put the proper numbers into the boxes. We cannot write the steps which are illuminated here, just we have to fill the empty boxes properly. So see here, we transfer this 2 to the 30 to the LHS, we'll get 33 multiplied by 2, that is 66. Now here we have the sum of the similar terms in this bracket, 2x plus x is 3x plus 1 as it is multiplied by x minus 4 as it is. Now here again some steps are illuminated, and directly the third or fourth step is given here. So we will write this part on the rough page and we will calculate it to get the proper numbers into the boxes. For getting the proper numbers to these boxes, we have to simplify this on the rough page. As we have given, 66 is equal to 3x plus 1 multiplied by x minus 4. 66 as it is, 3x multiplied by x is 3x square, minus 3x multiplied by 4 is 12x, plus 1 multiplied by x is 1x, plus 1 multiplied by minus 4 is minus 4. Now 66 remains as it is, this is 3x square minus 11x minus 4. Now transfer this 66 to the right side and we will get 3x square minus 11x minus 4 minus 66 is equal to 0, and we have 3x square minus 11x
minus 70 is equal to 0.
And now we have to compare this step with this step. We have 3x square, here we have 3x square, but see the sign, plus sign is given there in the textbook. And actually we have minus sign there. So we will simply put this sign into the box and we will write here minus 11x. Now we will get plus into minus, minus there. Or simply you can erase this sign and put minus there, but no need to make change in the steps which we have given into the textbook. So here we write plus sign as it is. In the box we write minus 11x. Now this minus sign is already given here, so just we have to put 70 in the next box. Now again we have to simplify this. Again some steps are illuminated from here, and we have given third or fourth step. Two steps are illuminated there. So we will simplify here. We have to take the factors of 3 multiplied by 70, that is 210, such that their difference is 11 and the factors are 10 and 21. Now our difference is negative, so bigger number is negative and smaller one is positive. So we can write it as 3x square minus 21x plus 10x minus 70 is equal to 0. Now from these two terms we can take 3x common, and inside the bracket x minus 7 is remaining, plus 10 is taken common inside the bracket, we have x minus 7 again. Now compare this step with this step. 3x into the bracket x minus 7, so here we have x minus 7 in this empty box or empty bracket. In the second empty bracket again we have x minus 7 here. Now 3x plus 10, see x minus 7 is taken common, and now in the second bracket it is remaining 3x plus 10 is equal to 0. We will simplify this again. If we take x minus 7 as common, inside the second bracket 3x plus 10 is remaining. Now we have 3x plus 10 is equal to 0, or x minus 7 is equal to 0. So here we write 3x plus 10 is equal to 0, or x minus 7 is equal to 0. We have x is equal to minus 10 upon 3, and we have x is equal to 7. Since the length is never negative, we not accepted this value, x is not equal to minus 10 upon 3, so x is equal to 7. Now we have to find the values of all the sides. AB is x, so x is equal to 7, so we have AB is equal to 7 centimeter. CD is given to x plus 1, so we will put 7 here, 7 to the 14 plus 1, 15 centimeter is there. And we have AD is equal to BC is equal to x minus 2, that is 7 minus 2 is equal to 5 centimeter. So this is all about this activity. We have to put the proper numbers into the proper boxes. Some steps were illuminated, some steps are skipped, so we have to take care about that, and we have to solve that steps on the rough page, and from that rough page we have to put the proper numbers here in this activity. So this is all about the practice set 2.6. We completed all the exercises, all the practice set from the second lesson, quadratic equation. Tomorrow we will take problem set 1. We are not going to take all the examples from problem set, but the examples which are different than the examples are in the practice set. We will take that examples only. Thank you.